Stay tuned for Tattletales, next over most of these CBS stations. Get ready to match the star, Artie Johnson, Brett Summer, Charles Nelson Reilly, from Busting Loose, Barbara Rose, Richard Dawson, and Patty Doyle, as we play the star-studded Big Money Match Game 77. And now, here's the star of Match Game 77, Gene Ragger.
Johnny O.
And a friend. Here are the beautiful people. You knew our set was orange because you've been on the show before, weren't you, Barbara?
Yes.
Nice to have you back again with us. Nice to have you back. Nice to have you back and you and you and you and all. What are you selling there? What was all that?
Oh, that was a sign that a fan sent. Is that terrific?
Somebody made that for you?
Yes.
What is it?
A little girl called Ann Rumsford.
What does it say?
Her daddy made it.
It says Clark Gable. Anybody can say that.
I should have put my glasses on.
Let's say hello to our current champion, Susan Stewart, over here. Susan has a total of $700 to her credit. She's won two games, and she won the last game just as our time expired last time, right?
Right.
And we're going to start with the audience match where you could win over $5,000. And that would really be a bundle for you, Susan.
Oh, yes.
You ready for that?
Yes.
All right, we'll be ready for that in a moment or so right after this.
Falls upon your streets to possess your eyes with tricks and treats.
If you could only feel what I'm feeling.
Costumed MCs.
Then
famous names.
I'm Vincent Price.
Fill y'all's TVs and haunt your games. No one can resist the wills to watch these Halloween chills and thrills. Starts October 29th only on Boozer.
Here we go, Susan. Are you ready?
Yes, I'm ready.
Let's get right to it, then. We polled a studio audience not too long ago, above average intelligence people like these right out here. And we got their best response to this. Mr. Blank. Mr. Blank. Now, we give you $500 if you match the answer they gave us most frequently. $250 for you if you match their second most popular answer, and then $100 for matching the third. And three of our six celebrities are allowed to help.
Help.
Richard.
Help.
Yeah, the gentleman does the best children's show on television. Won't you be my friend? Mr. Rogers.
Mr. Rogers, oh, isn't he wonderful?
Yeah, he's a good man. Really,
he really is. You're right. So there's one.
Charles.
Well, going to the White House, as I do so often, I'm accustomed to saying, Mr. President.
Of course.
And Brett.
I'm not affected at all.
Of course.
We're so grateful to you. What I'm still looking for, Mr. Wright.
Mr. Wright?
Yes.
So there they are, Mr. Wright, Mr. Rogers, Mr. President. You want one of those? Have you got a better idea?
I don't know. I was thinking of Mr. Ed.
Oh, yeah. You want to do that? Okay. She very hesitantly chose Mr. Ed. She's afraid that it might not be up there. What do you think? You think it might be there? Yeah. All right, that was a talking horse, wasn't it?
Yeah.
Okay, let's find out if we got a talking horse around here. May we see the $100 number? Mr. Magoo. Oh, another good one. Frank Backus there now. Okay, let's see if Mr. Ed is under the $250 number. Mr. Queen. Oh, there are some big ones here. I had no idea there's so many choices on these. All right.
Where was the panel?
You ready?
Yes.
All right, Earl, slide it. Oh, my goodness, you got it. Very good. Wow. She says, since I thought of it myself, I got to kiss someone, I'll kiss you. So she kissed me. And she's very good. Now, Susan, you picked up another $500 here, and you're going to play for 10 times that amount, or $5,000. You got to match one celebrity to collect.
Richard.
Okay, Richard, here we go.
Won't you be my friend.
Okay, worth $5,000. Good luck to you, Susan. Here it is. Time of blank. Time of blank. T-I-M-E. O-F, blank. Now, Susan, Richard had a difficult time making up his mind. You think about it, get some ESP flowing to him, and you'll come up with the same answer he's already written on the card.
Time of day.
Yay! Time of day. All right. Time of day is what she say. What do you say?
I said the time of your life.
Yeah. Well, I was torn. I sat there saying to myself, what would I do? Would I say time of day or time of your life? Would I say time of day or time of your life? That was really
good. Time of my life. I should have said it.
You're having the time of your life? You should have said it. Yeah. You're winning money
that
and all?
That was the thing that I was torn. You know, I didn't.
I know it. Yeah, that was a tough choice. Both answers were excellent. Susan, you've got $1,200 and a new challenger, Don Barry. Now, Don, you know this lady. We welcome you and ask you to tell us the Don Barry story, if you would, please.
I'm from Canoga Park, California. I'm a cook in a major restaurant in the San Fernando Valley. And for hobbies, I like to ride motorcycles and play the drums.
Really?
Yep.
And you grow mutton chops.
Oh, yeah?
No, these are called mutton chops, aren't they?
Oh, they are?
Yes.
From the British Navy.
That's right, exactly.
Never occurred to me.
Or sideburns from the American Army. There was a general during
Burnsides was his name.
Exactly. But he wore these things and people called him sideburns. Anything else you'd like to know before we go on there?
I'm ready to play.
Okay, well, no, we'll take the $500. What? We gave you the information. Now you pay us, Don. All right, right, good luck to Don. Here we go. You may have A or B.
I'll pick B, please.
You want B? B for Barry, he says. Here it is. Wherever Harry goes, people lick his head. And that's because instead of using Brill cream, Harry uses blank cream. This is an easy one. Why are you frowning? You're a college graduate. Wherever Harry goes, people lick his head, and that's because instead of using Brill cream, Harry uses blank cream.
That's nice.
All right. Ready. Put it right in the slot, Artie. Okay. And then that lights your light, you see, and I know you're finished. You got it.
I'm not finished. I'm Swedish. No, nothing is beneath me, darling.
No, never. It's her in the front of the
corner.
Wherever Harry goes, people lick his head. And that's because instead of using Brill cream, Harry uses blank cream.
Shaving cream.
You don't understand. I tell you what, Don, to make you understand, would you send in some shaving cream? I'll put some shaving cream on my head and you lick it and see what it's going to taste like then. Okay. He said shaving cream, Artie.
Well, he can say shaving cream, but I wouldn't lick shaving cream with your tongue. I said ice cream.
Ice cream. How's the cream, Ma? What do you say?
I said whipped cream.
Whipped
with
cream?
Honey.
Another good one. Really?
Honey.
Yes.
Show your sign again. I said ice cream.
Ice cream. Don Barry, you're getting the hang of it now, aren't you? Those are all excellent answers.
Here's a great answer.
Another good dip. All right, right here comes a goodie. Barbara Rhodes, what do you say?
Bristol cream.
Bristol cream. Oh. Yes, indeed. I think I might become a head licker for that, too.
Well, as the Maki Desad said, you certainly know how to show a guy a good time. Whip.
Okay, Patty.
Sour.
Sour cream. Some marvelous answers there.
Yeah.
The only rotten... Well, another one. Okay. The first ones are tough. You got to remember that. Hers is coming up in a moment. Right now, this for you. Now, first rounder for Susan. Susan, would you like A?
Yes, I'll take A.
Okay. Dumbdora so dumb. She tried to catch a blank with a catcher's mitt. That's how dumb she is. Dumbdora tried to catch a blank with a catcher's mitt. She tried to catch a blank with a catcher's mitt.
She tried to catch a blank with a catcher's mitt. Put it in the slot, huh?
No, I know, but I was thinking
about it. That's funny. I like that.
You're having second thoughts.
I always do.
I like
that.
I like his answer.
You know, I've had two marriages, so.
Susan, ready? Here we go. Dumbdora is so dumb, she tried to catch a blank with a catcher's mitt.
A man.
Catch a man. Hey, that's gonna be bad. Kind of cute answer. She tried to catch a man with a catcher's mitt.
Practical, bit practical.
Yes.
You always catch a man with a catcher's mitt and a shotgun.
Yes. White shotguns.
Do I always have to be under the gun?
No. You want her to go first?
Let her go first. She's much cleverer.
Okay, you
go
first.
It's a little play on words.
Yes.
I said she tried to catch a fly with a catcher's
mitt. Oh, yeah.
Same thing.
Now, you'd like to go second, would you?
Now I can have less embarrassment. She tried to catch a cold with a catcher.
That's a good answer. Nothing to be embarrassed about there.
I'm very sensitive.
When you give a clever answer like that, be proud of it. What?
Cold.
Cold. Dumbdora's so dumb, she tried to catch a blank with a catcher's mitt, Barbara.
I'm closer.
What?
I said a catcher, as in Steve Garvey.
Oh, yeah.
He's a man. No, he
That's
would
right.
be very
He's
upset.
He's with the Los Angeles Dodgers, isn't he? Yes,
so
indeed.
Definitely male.
Yes, definitely.
And all the males, you'll notice, are rather frigid. We all said cold.
You ready to help us,
Barbara?
Thank you.
Yeah. All right. Hard. How about you?
How about me?
Yes, that's everybody in the block is saying. What about her?
Uh-huh. I said a bus.
A bus is good. He had a little prize for the lady.
That's a
Let's one. Give her the award.
Wonderful.
Okay, so there's round one, folks, and as you can plainly see, it's a real hard-fought game. Okay, Don, A or B?
B, please.
Here we go. Norman doesn't have a jacuzzi. You know what a jacuzzi is. So when he wants to take a whirlpool bath, he hops into his blank. Doesn't have a jacuzzi, so when he wants to take a whirlpool bath, he hops into his blank. Good. In the slot, Artie.
Ta-da!
Here we go. I'll read it while they're finishing writing, Don. Norman doesn't have a jacuzzi, so when he wants to take a whirlpool bath, he hops into his blank.
Tub.
He was terrific in The Office.
Shaving cream.
Yes, he didn't.
I did.
Dive into the shaving cream.
I said shaving cream.
No kidding. Yes.
Oh, what is it? Do you want to ask
yes.
me something?
Yes. Whenever he wants to take a whirlpool bath, he hops into his...
I said blender.
Blender's a good one. All right.
Charles smells so good. It's just wafting all the way over here. He just smells adorable.
It's chopped
really?
Chicken liver. He rubbed his body with it.
Charles,
it
you
Ooh,
haven't taken
chicken liver.
You haven't taken to bathing again, have you?
Yes. I really did today. I took my weekly shower.
No kidding.
Yes. And I'm a friend of Monique Van Buren.
Yes.
This is true. And she said you always should have three different things on at once.
Holy mackerel.
Your underwear?
I think
a shirt
I'm in love with you,
else?
Charles.
Yes.
All right.
Dance card if anyone is interested.
Show us your answer.
Does he smell just like P&G soap?
Right.
Yes. I said washing machine.
There's a good one. There's two good ones so far. Show us yours. Another washing machine.
Washing machine.
Yes. Now, Barbara, Norman doesn't have a jacuzzi, so when he wants to take a whirlpool bath, he hops into his tub, according to Don.
No.
What, according to you?
His washing machine.
Washing machine is the definitive answer, I would say.
You, I think, once explained to me that above the equator line of certain places, the water in this particular answer of mine reverses direction.
Below the equator, it does.
Yeah, the tardy.
Is that true? You're surprised.
What direction does the water go here?
Here it goes clockwise.
Clockwise?
Below the equator, it goes counterclockwise.
I'm going to stay above that.
Right. Now, you, what do you say to this?
I said his whirlpool washer.
His whirlpool washer. So there you are.
Plug in.
See how it goes, John?
Yeah.
You're getting the hang of it.
Oh, yeah.
Too late.
Maybe.
Because if she blows it all together, you got another shot at it. We'll find out what happens right after we find out about this. Are you ready? You know what you have to do?
One.
One is all you need to win. Hey, did you hear?
What?
Superman had a mid-air collision with one of Santa's reindeer.
No.
Yes. Now Superman has an antler stuck in his blank. Okay, Artie, put it in the slot. And away we go. Susan, did you hear that Superman had a mid-air collision with Santa's reindeer? Would you like to hear about it?
Yes, I'd like to hear
it. Let me tell you what happened. Superman now has an antler stuck in his blank.
In his cape?
Oh.
Would you believe you got a chance? You got a chance.
Because
that answer is almost as dumb as the one you've been giving. She said cape.
Well, I'd think that's very sweet of her. Let's go to the next person. I don't want to talk. I know what they're doing. They're vulgar.
Come on now.
Yes. Oh, Hudson got stuck in his jockey shorts.
That's nice. He did wear those.
No. Everybody is wrong. He was facing her. It got stuck in his ass.
Yes.
Look up at the sky. It's a bird. It's a plane. It's Superman with an antler stuck in his ass.
Now, Charles.
Now, that was good.
That was very good.
I have to talk loud to get over the fumes from my cologne.
May I point out something to you? We do live in an electronic age. And these microphones are very sensitive and highly amplified. And you don't have to stick your head all the way down in there to talk to them. Just sit right up straight, and you can talk. Yeah, that's fine. You sound great, Charles. All right. Cut. Barbara, did you hear about Superman?
No.
Now Superman has an antler stuck in his blank.
In his nose.
Nose. Didn't I tell you he had a chance, Dan? Because a smart player like Richard would never say cape.
Well, we do live in electronic times.
Yes, we do.
And I have a sound man going.
What do you say?
Right in his ass.
Right in his ass. Boy. Well, here we are. They battled it out right down to the end here. 0-0 tie. Well, tiebreaker number one coming up. We may be, that's right. Okay, Don, you may have A or B.
I would like B again.
One for each. And the one who matches the most will be the winner here in the tiebreaker. The bionic woman's husband said, "It's tough being married to a woman who's part machine. It takes her 1 hour to change her clothes and another hour to change her blank." Tough being married to a woman who is part machine. It takes her 1 hour to change her clothes and another hour to change her blank. Now, there's one terrific answer to
there
this.
There is?
Yeah.
Do I have it?
She's got it. Okay. She's part machine.
Part machine.
Tough being married to a woman who's part machine. Takes her 1 hour to change her clothes, another hour to change her blank. Okay, here we go. Don Barry with his mutton chops. The bionic woman's husband said, "It's tough being married to a woman who is part machine. It takes her 1 hour to change her clothes and another hour to change her blank."
Batteries.
Batteries. Battery was one good choice. Let's see if it comes up.
I'll show you how great minds work together.
Yes.
And I have been consistent.
Battery. There's one. AC or DC is what he's asking.
Oh, she swings. I said it took her an hour to change her mind.
Change your mind.
Thank you, hon, whoever you are.
Yes. Charles, you are incorrigible. Incorrigible. Hello, Barbara. Yeah, oh. 1 hour to change her clothes and another hour to change her...
Oil.
Oil is... Oil. Probably the definitive answer.
Son of oil.
Son of oil. And Patty Doig.
Reprise of oil.
Three oil. So two for him, and yours will be along, but first we've got this for you.
Thank you.
Join us next time for Match Game 77. I'm Gene Rayburn. Tally ho.
This is Johnny Olsen speaking for Match Game 77. A Mark Fritz and Bill Todman production. Stay tuned for Tattletales next over most of these CBS stations.
From Hollywood, it's the Newlywed Game. And here are today's newlyweds. This couple celebrated their marriage 16 months ago, Kathy and Melvin Lambert. Our next couple did the iNews 3 months ago, Elizabeth and Robert Duje. This couple tied the knot 3 months ago, Danelle and Jeff Johnson. And our final couple exchanged rings 4 months ago, Yeniseth and Javier Birueta. And now, here's the star of the Newlywed Game, Bob Eubanks.
Thank you. Hello, everybody. Welcome to the Newlywed Game. Hey, special hello to our four couples. Are you ready to play our game?
Yes.
Then, ladies, do me a big favor. If you would, please go off to our soundproof room, and I'll ask the husband some questions. So, there you go. Now, gentlemen, round one, we'll be asking you some five-point questions, and you'll be answering these questions as you predict your wife will answer the same question when she returns. If her answer matches your prediction, you then get 5 points. And remember, each correct prediction brings you that much closer to that fabulous second honeymoon. So we're glad you're here, and here's your first question, gentlemen. The ladies are gone, and it goes like this. Say your wife's parents are house-sitting for you, and they start to snoop where they shouldn't. What's the one thing your wife will say they would be most shocked to find? Javier?
Well, they're going to see pictures of us in Tahiti in our honeymoon. I took pictures of her in her lingerie.
Oh. Robert, what are they going to be shocked to find? Her parents now are snooping around your house.
If they were snooping around the house, they'd find a video we made together. Yeah, it's dated and all, Bob. It's got dates on it
now,
and everything.
What was this like at a party, or what kind of video
It was more like a one-on-one video.
Oh! Okay. Melvin?
Video, dirty movie.
Oh, who's in it?
Different people.
Jeff?
I'd have to say lingerie pictures. She had some lingerie.
You're wearing lingerie pictures?
No.
Oh, she's wearing lingerie. Oh, I see. I'm sorry. Okay. Next question, gentlemen. In what one specific way will your wife say she is most like the car that you drive most often? In what way, Robert, is she like the car you drive most often?
She's gorgeous.
She's gorgeous.
My car. Gorgeous, just like my car.
Oh, isn't that sweet? Boring, but sweet, you know? Melvin, what way is she like the car you drive most often?
Ooh, like laying in bed. Sweet.
She's sweet?
Yeah.
Your car is sweet?
Sweet.
Jeff, what do you think?
Fast.
She's fast.
Definitely fast.
Right.
Definitely
Javier.
Fast.
I'm going to have to say fast because that's the way she likes it.
Next question, gentlemen. What will your wife say that someone actually did or did not have sex at your wedding? Melvin?
No.
Okay. Jeff?
Did not.
Did not. Javier?
Oh, did not.
Did not. Robert?
Did not.
That's the stupidest question I've ever heard, too.
Yeah.
I argued with Mr. Producer. He said, oh, everybody has sex at other people's weddings. Beat the heck out of me, folks, but we'll be right back to reunite the newlyweds, and we'll see how well our husbands have predicted what their wives will say right after these messages.
Tomorrow, starting at noon, Buzzr is the place to play with our most popular shows. That's why daytime is playtime.
Every day you must watch.
Tomorrow, starting at noon Eastern, only on Buzzr. Let's play.
game. Gentlemen, we've recorded your predictions on cards and now have them in front of you. Each time that your prediction matches your wife's answer, you get 5 points. Remember, it's the one couple with the most points at the end of the show that wins that fabulous second honeymoon. So, ladies, we're glad you're back. Here's your first question. Ladies, say that your parents are house-sitting for you, and they start to snoop where they shouldn't. What's the one thing you would say they would be most shocked to find in your house? Woo! Danelle? What would they be most shocked to find?
Toys, like in the...
What do you mean?
Nightstand.
I don't understand what you're talking about.
Like sex toys.
Jeff said, what's the matter, Jeff? No, your lingerie pictures. Her answer's better, Jeff.
My answer's better. Yeah.
What kind of toys do you have, Jeff?
Remote control cars.
We race them. You race them?
Yeah, late at night when there's nothing to do. It's real quiet. We race them, and the dog chases after them.
Oh.
It's a lot of fun.
That's why you have no points, because you're a liar. Kathy, what would they be shocked to find?
Sex toys.
You're kidding me. You too?
They're his.
They're what? They're his? What are they?
Sex toys.
Oh. Melvin said they would be shocked to find a dirty video.
Why? Why? Why then?
Why what?
They're both yours.
Let me see if I get this right. You got a dirty video and sex toys in your house. You pervert, you, Melvin. Elizabeth, what would they find? They would just shock them.
A video?
What kind of video?
One that he made me make.
He made you make that video. He forced you into doing that.
He sure did.
Oh. I don't believe you. He said they would find a one-on-one video. Yeah. Woo! Makes you all sweat, doesn't it? Yenny Seth, your parents are snooping around your house. What's the one thing they're going to find that would shock them?
A vibrator.
Why didn't you say that, Javier?
Well, I thought they knew because they gave it to her at her bachelor party.
He said they would find a card for me, please, Javier. No, they'd find pictures of you in lingerie.
You remember those?
Yeah.
I thought you hit those.
My goodness. Next question, ladies. In what one specific way would you say that you are most like the car that your husband drives most often? How are you most like the car that he drives most often? Kath?
Smooth inside.
You're smooth. All right. Melvin predicted you would say you're sweet. Why are you looking at me like that? Sweet and smooth are different.
You can't taste the car.
Elizabeth?
I'm going to have to say fun ride.
Robert said you're gorgeous.
Just like the car.
Come on, babe. Isn't that nice? Yeah. Yenny said?
Very fast.
You're fast. He said you're fast, yeah. Danelle.
I'm gonna have to go with fast.
You're fast. He said you're fast too. Okay. This is the last of our questions. Ladies, would you say that someone actually did or did not have sex at your wedding? Did they or did they not have sex at your wedding, Elizabeth?
Did not.
Did not?
Did not.
I'm amazed.
Other than us, nobody else.
Oh, whoa, whoa. You had sex at your own wedding?
Well, no, but the day of the wedding, but we're the only ones as far as I know.
All right. Robert said the answer is no, they did not, okay. Yenny said? I'm sorry?
No, they did not.
No, they did not. Your husband predicted you would say that. No, they did not. Janelle?
Did not.
Did not. And Jeff said they did not. Okay. Kathy?
They did not.
Did not. Everybody gets that one right, isn't that funny? We'll be back with the wives to see how well they predict what their husbands will say right after these messages. Welcome back to the Newlywed Game. Ladies, your husbands are now secluded off stage, and it's your turn to predict what they will say. Remember, these questions are now worth 10 points. Wait till you hear this one. Ladies, if your husband had to spend the rest of today's show in drag, which half do you think he would opt for, his top half or his bottom half? If he had to spend the rest of the show in drag, Elizabeth, which do you think he'd opt for, his top half or his bottom half?
I'm going to have to say his top half.
Top half, you think.
Yeah.
Okay. Kathy?
I'd say the bottom half.
His bottom half.
Yeah.
Okay. Danelle?
His top half.
Top half. All right. Yanni Smith? Yanni Seth?
His top half.
His top half, also.
Yes.
Next question, ladies. Who will your husband say he would find most threatening to your marriage? A smarter man, a richer man, or a sexier man? Kath?
Sexier man.
A sexier man. Danelle?
A sexier man. He doesn't think he's that sexy, but he's sexy, but I think he'd think a
well,
sexy
is he sexy
man.
Or not?
Well, he is very sexy to me.
Yeah, to you.
But
yeah.
I think he would find a sexy man threatening.
Be very threatening to
yeah.
him. Okay. Yanni Seth?
I would have to say a richer man.
A richer man would be threatening.
Yes.
Look at the dollar signs in her eyes. Elizabeth?
I would have to say a richer man, too.
A richer man would be threatening to your marriage.
Yeah.
Next question, ladies. What two words will your husband say best describes his butt? Give me two words that describe his butt, Danelle.
Round and hard.
Round and hard. Yanni Seth?
Big and round.
Big and round. Elizabeth?
Big and tight.
Big and tight. Kathy?
Flat and flat.
Ha ha ha! Here's our 25-point bonus question. Ladies, will your husband say he prefers his Toll House cookies with or without a couple of nuts? Yenny, Seth?
Without.
Without. Elizabeth?
I'm going to say with.
With a couple of nuts. Kathy?
With nuts.
With nuts. Danelle?
Without. He's already got his own.
There's nothing in the question that talks about that. Okay, we'll be right back now with the husbands and comparisons on the video game. Right after these nothing. To the newlywed game. Three of our couples have 10 points. Couple number two has 5 points, but we're going to see how well they do in this round. Remember, ladies, these are the 10-point questions. Now, normally, you know, we come back, we have the couples here. But before the break, we ask our wives, if your husband had to spend the rest of today's show in drag, which half do you think he would opt for, his top half or his bottom half? Now, we're going to see how well they predicted. You ready to do that? Let's say, Kathy, now you predicted that Melvin would opt for what? Can I see the top card for me, please? For his bottom half. You thought it would be, well, Melvin, come out here if you would, please. Bring Melvin out. Oh, Melvin! Look at you! You got the points! You got the points!
I got the leg.
You got the, well, yeah. Those suckers go all the way up, don't they? Yeah. You got a boo-boo on your knee. What have you been doing? Okay, go over there and sit down, but be sure to cross your legs, okay? Hey, Melvin. Now, Melvin, can you cross your legs all the way over? No, Melvin, do it like a girl does it, you know. All the way, Melvin. All the way. Yeah. That's it, yeah. Elizabeth, what did you say, Elizabeth? That he would, he'd opt for his top half? Well, let me find. Robert, come out here, would you please, Robert? Where's Robert? Robert, do me a favor, okay? Yeah, do me a big favor. Don't put your hands there. Okay. Thank you very much. There you go, sit down. Hey, Elizabeth, you thought his parents were going to be mad over the toys. Wait till you see this. He actually looks pretty kind of good this way, doesn't he? Yeah. Okay, Jenny said, you thought your husband would opt for what? For his top half. Let's see. Javier, where are you, Javier? Javier! Hey, Javier. What do you do for a living, Javier? Huh? What do you do for a living?
Walk the boulevard.
Oh, you walk the boulevard. I see. All right. She said you would opt for your top half. Go sit down if you would, please. Man, I'll tell you, wait till the guys in the hood see Javier. Huh? Your reputation is over, pal. I mean, oh, Danelle, I bet you're nervous. Yeah, I bet you are. You thought your husband would opt for what? Yeah, his top half. Let's find out. Jeffrey, where are you? Here's Jeff. Oh, Jeff. You have to stay away from me, sir. Go sit down there with your wife, okay? First of all, just let me say this. You guys are wonderful sports. You really are. Hey, Melvin, does it hurt to cross your legs like that? All right, gentlemen, next question. Gentlemen, who would you find more threatening to your marriage, a sexier man, a smarter man, or a richer man, Robert?
A richer man.
Richer man?
Yeah, see, richer. Yeah. Not sexier. Look.
Yeah, you are sexy.
Can't get sexier than this.
Yeah. What do you do for a living?
What do I do for a living? I work at a major department store.
A major department store. In which department do you work in, sir?
Electronics.
Oh, good, yeah. Oh, yeah, you're the guy with all the toys. Yeah.
No, okay. That's the...
Oh, that's that. So, richer man, you say. She predicted you would say it would be a richer man. Yeah. I swear to God, I feel like Jerry Springer. I really do. Javier.
I would say a richer man.
A richer man. All right. Richer man. Yeah.
Yeah, I love you.
Jeff, what scares me is Jeff is starting to like this. That really scares me. Jeff, what would be more threatening, a sexier, or smarter, or a richer man?
Definitely smarter man, because a smarter man would not have let her do this to him.
Oh, yeah. No. She said, you're right. A sexier man would be threatening.
Oh, honey.
Hey, do me a favor, Danelle. Don't hit a woman, okay?
There is no sexier. Look at this.
Melvin.
This is sexy.
Look at old Melvin sitting there with his hands crossed, his legs crossed. Melvin, I'm telling you. I'm telling you, your friends. You look so funny. Which would be threatening, Melvin?
Sexier man.
Sexier man. She predicted you would say it would be a sexier man. Yeah.
That's what I'm talking about.
Here's the last of our 10-point questions. Gentlemen, what two words would you say best describes your butt? What two words, Javier, best describes your butt? Javier, don't look at me like that.
Pretty big.
Pretty big. All right. She said two words would be big and round. Close, but no cigar. All right. Okay. Jeff, what two words best describes your butt?
Very round.
Very round. She predicted you would say round and hard.
Oh.
Oh.
It's pretty hard.
Melvin.
I got half of them.
Flat butt.
flat butt. She said describing your butt would be flat and flat.
Flat and flat.
Well, there's no other way to describe it. Only one word is flat, flat, flat.
Flat, flat.
Flat, flat. Flat.
Okay. Robert, two words.
Definitely big and round.
Big and round. She said definitely big and tight. Before we get to our 25-point bonus question, let's see where our eight girls will be going on their second honeymoon.
Well, ladies, you're going to Mexico. You'll stay at the Hotel Cabo San Lucas, a complete beach resort where you can do everything under the sun or nothing at all. White sand beaches, elegant dining, and deluxe accommodations, all with private terraces. The perfect second honeymoon. Back to you, Bob.
Thank you, Kramer, very much. Okay, here it is, our 25-point bonus question. And if you just tuned in and see the couples like this, you'll just have to guess for yourself. 25-point bonus question. Gentlemen, do you prefer your Toll House cookies with or without a couple of nuts? Couple number one. Jeff and Danelle, you have 20, 25, I give you 45. Get it right, you'll be in first place. Jeff, with or without?
Definitely with.
With. She said definitely without. Oh, couple number two, Melvin and Kathy with 25, 25, I give you 50. With or without a couple of nuts, Melvin?
With.
With, she said. With a couple of nuts, yes. Couple number three, Robert and Elizabeth. With 30, 25, I give you 55. Robert, what do you say?
With.
With, she said with, yeah. All right, couple number four. Yenny, Seth, and Javier, you have 30, 25, gives you 55. Get it right, and you're tied for the lead. Miss it, and you go home in third place. Javier?
With?
With. She said, without. That means a couple number three. Robert and Elizabeth. Yeah, newlywed game grand prize winners. Congratulations to Robert and Elizabeth. You guys were wonderful. Thank you so very much for being such great sports. I'm Bob Eubanks. We will see you next time. Bye-bye.
From Hollywood, it's the Newlywed Game. And here are today's newlyweds. This couple became husband and wife 5 months ago, Gundi and Joseph Chatka. Our next couple marched down the aisle 13 months ago, Dana and Quentin Sledge. This couple sliced their wedding cake 20 months ago, Sheila and Richard Travers. And our final couple traded vows 2 months ago, Lori and Jeremy Deckard. And now, here's the star of the newlywed game, Bob Eubanks.
Oh, hey, hello, everybody. Welcome to the newlywed game. Hey, you guys. Are you ready to play my game? Then I'll tell you what let's do. Let's send the ladies off to our soundproof room where there are male strippers waiting for them. No, I'm just kidding. And while you're gone, we'll ask the husband some questions. Go, ladies, if you would, please. And gentlemen, around one, we'll be asking you some 5-point questions. You'll be answering these questions as you predict your wife will answer the same question when she returns. Now, remember, if her answer matches your prediction, you then get 5 points. And also remember, it's the couple with the most points at the end of the show that wins that great second honeymoon. So the ladies are gone. Here's your first question for 5 points. Gentlemen, when it comes to body language, will your wife say you communicate best with your eyes, your mouth, or your hands? Jeremy?
The hands.
The hands.
Lori loves the hand motion. All over the hand motion.
You're kidding me.
Hey, the best I could do. Hands.
Huh. Okay. Quentin.
Dana likes me to express myself with my eyes.
Your eyes?
Yeah, I'm always touching her, but I give her that one look and...
What look is that? I got it. Okay. Joseph?
Definitely my hands.
The hands?
Always in her pants.
You old pervert. Richard!
I'd have to say the eyes. They're also in her pants.
They're all talk, believe me. Next question, gentlemen. How much will your wife say her brain weighs? I need your answers in pounds and or ounces. How much do you think her brain weighs, Quentin?
Probably 100 pounds.
Your answer is 100 pounds?
100 pounds.
Well, your brain doesn't weigh 100 pounds if your answer is 100 pounds for her. I'll tell you that. Joseph.
I'd say she's a very smart woman, but the human brain is very heavy, so I said 2 pounds.
2 pounds?
2 pounds.
Makes you feel kind of stupid sitting next to a guy who's married to a woman with a 100-pound brain, doesn't it? Richard.
My wife has a 100-pound brain with stuck into 2 pounds.
So what's your answer?
2 pounds.
2 pounds. Thank you. Jeremy.
I try to top that. She's got about a 4-pound brain.
4 pounds?
The 100 pounds of attitude.
Bad. Bad attitude?
No, great attitude. She's just, if you know her, she's really socially inclined. So she's got a good attitude.
What the heck does that mean?
I don't know, but...
Sounded good.
Sounded good.
Don't use your new words on me, okay? All right, gentlemen, here's the last of our 5-point questions. Gentlemen, how will your wife say you would complete this sentence? Now, this is you talking. My wife's sexual desires don't stop at the bedroom door. She once seduced me where? Joseph.
The backyard.
Where?
The backyard.
The backyard?
By the pool, yeah.
Really? Out in the backyard by the pool.
That's right.
Well, you lucky devil. Where were the neighbors?
I got all privates.
Oh, you got all privates.
Yeah,
good.
No.
All right. It's a good thing for a guy to have, you know? Richard.
The San Diego Comic Convention in a storage closet.
In a storage closet at the San Diego Comic Convention. Sounds good to me. Jeremy.
Laguna Beach.
Where at Laguna Beach?
Down on the sand.
Oh, little victory at sea thing going.
Hey,
I see.
After a couple of wampu lompus at one of the lounges, we were ready to roll.
After a couple of what, sir?
Wampu lompus.
You had 2 wampu wampus?
We had 3.
3 wampu wampus? Yeah.
And then, we had some lompu lompu after that.
See, I'm not sure what that is, so I'm not going to comment, okay? Quentin.
In her niece's bedroom.
In her niece's bedroom?
Yes, in her niece's bedroom.
Where was her niece?
Her niece wasn't there. Her niece was out of town.
Wow. Boy, that was dangerous.
It was dangerous, all right.
Congratulations,
thanks.
By the way. You're welcome. We'll be right back to reunite these newlyweds, and we'll see how well our husbands have predicted what their wives will say right after these messages. The newlywed game. Gentlemen, we recorded your predictions on cards. You now have them in front of you. Now remember, each time that your prediction matches your wife's answer, you're going to get 5 points. I lied to you, not 10. 5 points. And it's the couple with the most points at the end of the show that's going to win that great second honeymoon. So good luck to you. Ladies, nice to have you back. Ladies, when it comes to body language, would you say your husband communicates best with his hands, his eyes, or his mouth? Sheila, how's he communicate best when it comes to body language? His hands, his eyes, or his mouth?
His mouth.
His mouth?
Yeah. I can never get him to shut up. It's just everything's with his mouth. Mouth this, you know?
Oh, so he talks a lot.
Well, he talks a lot and his mouth.
Richard predicted you would say that he communicates best with his eyes, he said.
Oh, but you're always talking all the time. I can never get you to
shut up.
Yeah,
but it's not body language.
Ask anybody. You're all mouth.
Goondi.
I would say his hands.
He communicates best with his hands.
Yes.
He predicted you say he communicates best with, card for me please, his hands. Yeah. All right. Dana. Yes. How does he communicate best? With his hands, eyes, or mouth?
His eyes.
His eyes.
Definitely
really?
His eyes.
How come?
He looks like a lost puppy.
Quentin said he communicates best with his eyes. Yeah, you got it. Lori.
I would definitely have to say Jeremy communicates best with his mouth because
his mouth.
It's so big. And he always gives like a big lip when he's sad. He goes,
aw, big old baby. Jeremy said he communicates best with his hands.
His hands.
Yeah. He said he's all over you with his hands. Next question, ladies. How much would your husband say your brain weighs? I need your answer in pounds and or ounces. Gundy, how much did Joseph say your brain weighs?
I would say at least 100 ounces.
What'd you say? 2 pounds. 2 pounds.
I have a 100-ounce brain. I mean, Jesus Christ, your head is all this power.
Hey, you old weirdo, watch your mouth.
Yeah, watch your mouth.
Dana?
Probably 10 pounds.
10 pounds. You know what he said? 10 pounds?
10 pounds.
He said, your head would be down on the ground. He said, your brain weighs 100 pounds.
It does.
Oh, that's nice. It's wrong, but it's nice. Lori?
I go with 12 pounds.
Your brain weighs 12
sure.
pounds?
Maybe coupled with an arm.
Yeah. No, 4 pounds, your brain weighs.
4 pounds.
Yeah. What do you think about this 12. One, Sheila?
He better have said 10 pounds.
10 pounds? Yeah. You know what he said? He says, oh, I was so embarrassed when he said this. He said, my wife's brain only weighs 2 pounds.
He did not.
Look at the card.
Said there was 100 pounds of information.
Oh, don't bail out on me. All right, ladies, here's the last of your five-point questions. Ladies, how did your husband complete this sentence? This is him talking. He said, my wife's sexual desires don't stop at the bedroom door. She once seduced me where? You once seduced him where, Dana?
In the living room.
In the living room. Boy, you're an adventurous person, aren't you?
Yeah. At 2 o'clock in the morning.
At 2 o'clock in the morning. Quentin said you once seduced him. I'm embarrassed for you about this one. Let me see. In your niece's bedroom.
Quentin.
Everybody knows you're going to do it in the house.
Can you believe that?
Everybody knows you're going to do it in the house, babe. You got to go outside someplace.
Lori, you once seduced him where?
I'd have to say the beach, Bob.
The beach, Bob?
You betcha.
Really? Did you get sand in your pants?
Just a little.
I see. I'm sorry. Jeremy predicted you would say it would be down at the sand of Laguna Beach. You got it. Okay. Sheila. Sheila, you once seduced him. I'm so embarrassed for you.
I know. There's other people who know.
Yeah, I know.
They're going to go, there's that girl.
Yeah, there's that one right there. Yeah. What's your answer?
A comic convention.
Was it that funny?
Well, no, we got caught. It was embarrassing.
Who caught you?
The maintenance people.
The maintenance people at the comic convention?
Yeah, and then they go, hey, lady, what are you doing?
Wait a minute. Were you by yourself? Oh, you were with him.
They couldn't see him, and I said nothing, and they go, oh my gosh, Roll, you want us to leave? We'll turn out the lights, and he popped up, and he went, no, we're
oh, good.
Leaving.
I'm glad he popped up anyway. Richard predicted you would say, yeah, the storage closet, the San Diego Comic Convention. You got it. Boy, Goonie's sitting over there just shaking her head. Goonie, you once seduced him where?
I in the backyard.
No!
Oh, yeah.
Anybody catch you?
Oh, no, we have a high wall.
Oh, you do?
Yeah, we sunbathe in the nude.
You do what?
Sunbathe in the nude.
You're kidding me.
Of course, it's the only way to go.
You mean without clothes on, too?
Yes, and sometimes he gets freckles, you know where.
Joseph said, I don't want to see in the backyard. Okay. We'll be back to see how well the wives can predict what their husbands will say right after these messages.
darkness falls upon your streets to possess your eyes with tricks and treats.
If you could only feel what I'm feeling.
Costumed MCs.
Good evening.
Then famous names.
I'm Vincent Price.
Fill y'all's TVs and haunt your games. No one can resist the wills to watch these Halloween chills and thrills. Starts October 29th only on Boozer.
Hey, welcome back to the Newlywed Game. Now, ladies, your husbands have been all secluded off stage. It's your turn to predict what they will say. And remember, these are the big ones because you guys are smarter. These questions are worth 10 points. And here's our first question. Oh, before we start the first question, I want you to meet Victoria. Victoria, would you come out here, please? Ladies, I want you to meet Victoria. Now, ladies, according to the Kinsey Institute, men think about sex every 30 minutes. Now, if Victoria moved in next door to you, how often will your husband say he would be thinking about it then, Dana?
Every 15 minutes.
15 minutes? You think that would, it might double his thought process?
It may double it.
Okay. Gundy, what do you think?
I think he would want to do it every 10 minutes. However, I don't think he could.
Well, you would know if anybody would, yeah.
That's right.
Okay, Sheila, how often would you think about sex?
I'm going to say every 25 minutes.
So only about 5 more minutes?
Yeah.
That's all that Victoria would... Okay. Lori?
It'd probably be every 30 seconds.
Every 30 seconds? All right. Victoria, thank you very much. Thank you. All right. Next question, ladies. Which specific part of your husband's physical anatomy will he admit is shaped all wrong for the rest of his body? What part of his physical anatomy, Gundy, is shaped all wrong for the rest of his body?
I think his nose.
His nose
he
is.
He complains about his nose.
What's the matter with his nose?
He says it's too big.
Big nose.
Yeah.
Okay, Sheila?
I'm going to say his butt.
His butt is shaped all wrong for the rest of his physical body. Lori?
It's easy. It's his big old butt.
It's his big old
big
butt.
Big old butt.
Big one.
You betcha.
No, you betcha. Dana.
Quentin's love handles. His waist.
His waist yeah. is shaped all wrong for the rest of his body.
He thinks so. I think it's fine.
All right, fine. 25-point bonus question. Ladies, what will your husband say is the nickname of his all-time favorite sports team? The nickname of his all-time favorite sports team. Lori? Pretty please.
Packers.
Pardon me?
Packers.
The Packers. Fine. Dana?
Chicago Bulls.
The Bulls. The Bulls. The Bulls. Gundy.
I say also the Chicago Bulls. Can
the
I
Bulls.
Do that?
Is Pardon
that,
me?
Is that permissible that well, I
is?
Say the same?
Well, you know, let me check with the judge. Yeah, judge, yeah. Sheila?
Chicago Cubs.
The Cubs.
The
All
Cubs.
Right. Ladies, thank you very much. We'll be right back with the husbands to compare answers on the Newlywed Game. Right after these messages.
Thank you.
back, everybody. We have some delightful couples today. Everybody scored points. Congratulations. Let's see how well you do now, gentlemen, because we're going to see how well your wives have predicted what you will say. And remember, these are the big ones. These are the 10-point questions. Here's our first one. Gentlemen, I want you to meet a friend of mine. Victoria, would you please come out here for just a moment? Could we get Victoria? Joseph, you're making a total fool of yourself. Just want you to know that. Holy cow. I apologize for Joseph. I really do. Gentlemen, according to the Kinsey Institute, men think about sex every 30 minutes. Put your tongue back in your mouth, Jeremy. Now, if Victoria moved in next door to you, how often would you be thinking about sex then? Joseph?
All day long.
She said you'd think about sex. Top card for me, please. She said every 10 minutes you would think about sex. Quentin.
Probably a minute.
Every minute?
No, I wouldn't.
You know, your wife said you would think about sex probably every 15 minutes.
No. You know my preferences.
Jeremy, Kinsey reports says men think about sex every 30 minutes. She moves in next door to you. How often are you going to think about sex?
Wouldn't change. Every minute still.
Close. No.
Oh, every 30 seconds,
every
your wife says.
Second.
That's a minute?
That's 60 seconds, silly.
Well, you know how I judge things, 30 seconds a minute to me.
Richard.
I'd have to say every 30 seconds.
Richard, look up here. Every 30 seconds. Your wife said you'd think about sex every 25 minutes.
I can't believe you. We're around women like this constantly. What are you talking
about?
We
are?
Yes.
Oh, yeah, we are.
Jesus.
Victoria, thank you very much. Appreciate it.
It makes no difference to you.
All right, thank you. Next question, gentlemen. Tell me, what specific part of your physical anatomy would you say is shaped all wrong for the rest of your body? What part of you, Quentin, is shaped all wrong for the rest of your body?
Definitely my waistline.
Your waistline?
I can't get my waistline down to where I want it to be, and I'd be a perfect 10 if I can get my waistline down.
Well, at least you have confidence. I like that. You don't think much about sex, but you do have confidence. All right? Dana said it would definitely be your card for me. That's the only one you need, huh?
Okay.
That's the one. Your waist, that's it. You got it. Okay. Hey, Jeremy, I know you think you're a perfect 10, but what part of your physical anatomy was shaped all wrong for the rest of your body?
Probably have to be my butt.
What's the matter with your butt?
Towing a trailer.
Towing a trailer. She said, you are towing a trailer. Yay! Yeah. Richard.
You didn't have to get it right. After many beers, I'd have to say the gut.
The old gut, yes.
The old beer gut.
Yeah, the old beer gut. You know what she said? She said, it's your butt.
Your butt. Your flat butt. I always say, your butt looks so different. I can't believe it's on your body.
What are you, nutty? All you do is sit and go, God, that beer gut, you've got to get rid of that. Go to the gym.
Basically,
your butt. No.
Basically, what it boils down to, she's not happy with the back or the front. Joseph.
My chest.
What's the matter with your chest?
No hair on it.
What? Nothing? Dang, you must be a 36B. She said it would be your nose.
You always complain about
that. All right, before we get to our 25-point bonus question, let's see where our winning couple will be going on their second honeymoon. Kramer!
You're going to Antigua. You'll stay at the famous St. James Club in Antigua, an idyllic all-inclusive resort, boasting beaches, water sports, tennis, entertainment, and more. The St. James Club, Antigua. Have a fabulous second honeymoon. Back to you, Bob.
Thank you, John, very much. All right, gentlemen, here it is. No talking. Here's our 25-point bonus question for 25 points. Gentlemen, What's the nickname of your all-time favorite sports team? Nickname of your all-time favorite sports team. Couple number one, Richard and Sheila, you have 525 and give you 30. Richard, get it right, you'll be in first place. Miss it, you go home in last place after telling everybody you made love in a closet at a comedy convention.
The Cubs.
Cubs, he said. The Cubs, yes. Couple number two, Joseph and Gundy, you have 10, 25 and give you 35. Joseph, take over the lead with the correct answer. Yes, Joseph. Hit him again.
Say something.
No, for the Angels.
The Angels. All right. She said it's the Bulls. The Bulls. No. Couple number three. Quentin and Dana with 15, 25 gives you 40. Get it right, you'll be in first place. Quentin, what's your answer?
I'm a Chicago Bulls fan.
The Bulls. She said it would be the Bulls.
Yeah.
Couple number four, Jeremy and Loria, 15, 25 gives you 40. Jeremy, get it right, you're tied for the lead. Miss it, you go home in third place. What's your answer?
Gotta be, I watch SportsCenter every night, the Angels.
The Angels, she said, the Packers. That means a couple number three, Quentin and Dana. You're our Newlywed Game Grand Prize winners. Well, congratulations to you, kid. Thanks to all of our couples, and thanks to you at home for watching our show. I'm Bob Eubanks, and we will see you next time. Bye-bye.